Welcome back to Adams Field. Halftime, Slippery Rock leads Wayne State 49-14. I'm pleased to be joined at halftime by the athletic director for Wayne State University, Rob Fournier. Rob, good to see you again, sir.
Good to see you, Tony.
Well, the last time we talked on this stage, you said, and I'm quoting here, that you would have a special announcement. Well, that cat's out of the bag. We can thank Rob Beard for that. But I need to ask, how did that whole deal go down with the new arena that's
and
going to be built?
I'm surprised you weren't there, Tony, after I gave you the tip that it was coming.
And I know, Rob
beat me first, to I'm it. Looking around, and I'm like, yeah. Well, that was 3 years in the making. Mm-hmm. Just a lot of work behind the scenes. Pistons have been great. Arne Tellem is great. And Richard Adder, General Counsel, Josh Bartlestein, their chief of staff. I mean, just great people to work with. And literally it all started just with a cold call. Picked up the phone one day and I was thinking, okay, they've got their team down here. They got their new facility close to campus. What about their G League team? And, you know, I just floated the idea out there to them. And then a couple of weeks after that, next thing you know, Arne Tellem's down in my office and we're talking arena. So it's been fun.
How important and critical was that partnership with the Pistons in getting everything done? And for that matter, getting their G League team down here, which is something I'm sure they wanted, to get it closer than Grand Rapids.
Well, now, I mean, talk about organizational efficiency. Mm-hmm. Everything is within, you know, I mean, literally a stone's throw away is their new $80 million practice facility, which is by far the best in the NBA. And then you got Little Caesars, and then now you're just going to take a couple blocks over here to Wayne State. You got your G League team. You can move your players in and out. You don't have to worry about them traveling a long distance. I mean, it's a perfect setup, and obviously it was something that we saw that we could take advantage of.
Rob, what's the timetable on this? When does the arena get built? When's the first game at
July 31st, 2021, Tony.
Nice.
You and I are walking through that door together.
Absolutely.
And then we're going to play a nice team, probably from the Big Ten, to open it up.
Wait a minute. Wayne State's going to play a team from the Big Ten.
Well, those first few games, they don't count.
Yeah.
So we need something to draw the fans in, you know. So
could it be a Big Ten team from down the road, perhaps?
Well,
you won't say?
I guess there's 12 of them we could pick from, but we'll get one of them.
With the arena now on the drawing boards and on its way towards completion, what's next for you, Wayne State-wise, and improving athletically?
Well, important for your guys upstairs.
Yeah.
Next year at this time, the new elevator. So they're going to go up, and, you know, if they want to keep going up and down and stuff, they can do it as much as they want. Although I understand Rod, he needs help with the buttons and stuff. But
no, that's Joe that needs the help with the buttons.
Yeah, so that's next. And then, of course, we're doing the practice field over here next to us behind the football stadium, which will be for intramural and club sports. It will be great for the students on campus here for their activities.
I want to talk to you about a very impressive feat that I saw that involves Warrior Athletics, but it's off the field. 74% of your players across various sports have grade point averages of 3.0 or higher. What does that say about the importance of academics here at Wayne State, as well as the athletics?
Well, we put an emphasis on academic success. I mean, you know, I think sometimes people get a little critical sometimes. The approach is maybe, it's okay if you miss a practice.
Right.
It's okay if you can't go to a game because of academics. But in reality, I mean, we're a Division II program.
Mm-hmm.
Although I love being on Comcast, we're not going to be mistaken for a, you know, network weekend game.
Right.
So we're going to emphasize what we do best. You know, every team has above a three-point grade point average. That includes football.
Right.
Our graduation rate is 78%. So those are things we're proud of. And we think those kids are the kids that will make an impact in the community going forward. And that's something we're very proud of.
And that was something, when you took over as athletic director here at Wayne State, that you wanted to improve on quickly almost two decades ago, which was the academic portion of the Wayne State sports programs.
Has it been that long, Tony?
Yeah, it has been that long.
That worked out.
Doesn't feel that long, but it's been that long.
Well, you know, our pillars are based on academic success, community outreach. This is the seventh year in a row our kids have volunteered over 10,000 community service hours.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's just phenomenal. And those are activities they choose. I mean, those aren't things that we pick out and, you know, tell them to go to. You sometimes see that with professional teams. They'll line up a photo op where people go out to a place. And I'm not disparaging that in any way.
No.
But our kids actively want to get involved and do things and help out kids in the inner city. And I think a reason they do so well in school is that combination of that community outreach, and they realize the gifts they've been given, and they work a little bit harder at their academic success.
And that's important to you. It's important to everybody on this campus to be able to help out inside the community, as well as the community has supported you over the years.
Well, you know, I just really think that drives home for the kids, you know, what's your priorities in life?
Mm-hmm.
What do you put your emphasis on? You know, for some kids, they've not really ever been introduced to that before. And then they see the seniors and juniors doing it, and they're like, oh, okay. And then they create a relationship with an elementary school or with a young kid they're mentoring. And, you know, they grow from that. And then it doesn't stop when they leave Wayne State. You know, that's something they carry with them for the rest of their lives. And it's, you know, it's just part of the education that we do.
Because of all the work you do in the community and how Wayne State has operated throughout the years, Wayne State has now become Detroit University.
I'm sorry, Detroit School.
Detroit University, Detroit School.
Yeah, I think, I mean, what we represent to the community, I think when you just drive around this area,
mm-hmm.
I mean, I was talking to the athletic director from the team we're playing today, and he was last here 10 years ago, and he was like, this place is just completely different. And
right.
I said, yeah. I says, you know, the neighborhoods around here, you know, great credit to President Wilson and the board, their leadership and what they've done. And it's just been transformational.
One more thing about this. Looking down the list of all the athletes that have those 3.0 grade point averages, it's not just one or two sports. It's across the entire board. So does that create a competition among the various sports? Baseball competes with football, who competes with softball, who competes with men's and women's tennis. Does that kind of compete, kind of competition
well,
go on?
It's a friendly competition.
Yeah,
but
well.
Athletics is driven by competition.
Mm-hmm.
We actually want to win this football game today. Some of the fans may not think that looking at us. But I think that's Americana. That's
mm-hmm.
what it's about. You want to be the best. And, you know, it's interesting. We started a program called 4 Points to Perfection, which
mm-hmm.
is a luncheon that one of our key donors, Gary Spicer, puts on every year. And we started a few years ago. We had 23 4 points. So if you get a perfect 4 point, you get to go to a luncheon at the DAC.
Right.
This past semester, 46. And the kids, they realize, hey, if I get a 4 point, I get the lunch.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's something that incentivizes them. And people might look at that and think, oh my gosh, you know, it's just a lunch. But we really celebrate that. And, you know, people get dressed up. We bus them down to the DAC. They have a nice lunch. They see a part of the city that many of them haven't seen before.
Right.
And it is an incentive for them. And it's that kind of competition drives them, but it drives them in a good way.
Talk to one of your four-pointers earlier, Hunter Brown, who's here. Of course, fifth-round draft pick of the Houston Astros. And somebody who came back here, Anthony Pittman was back here earlier. So that's something else you've got to be proud of, that the athletes who graduate are anxious to come back here, spend time at Wayne State, and teach the next class that follows them.
You know, funny thing about Hunter Brown,
yeah.
Coach Kelly, you know, talked to him last year. He says, you know, Hunter, you're good enough the way you throw the ball. You're going to get some looks. There are going to be some scouts taking a look at you. And he says, well, Coach, how do I make myself, you know, more presentable?
Mm-hmm.
And he goes, I'm going to challenge you to go out and get a 4 point. And he went out and got a 4 point. So he's the GLIAC, not the pitcher of the year, he's the GLIAC student athlete of the year, and he gets a perfect 4 point in the Mike Ilitch School of Business. I mean, that's a pretty challenging program.
That's very good.
And, you know, that's just the type of kid we have.
Rob Fournier, thank you very much for the time. I'll be looking forward to the elevator next year and looking forward to walking through the door with you in 2021 at the new basketball
arena. Mark that date down, Tony.
Oh, I'm going to be at the front door. I'm waiting on you. I am going to absolutely wait on you.
You're a front door guy, Tony.
Exactly. The cameras will be there to watch us walk through the front door together.
We're taking Joe in the back, but you're coming in the front.
Well, no, Joe and Rod have to step behind us.
Okay, all right.
Rob Fournier, the athletic director at Wayne State, joining us here at halftime. Slippery Rock leads Wayne State 49-14. Second half action coming up next on Comcast CN 900.